Hello and welcome back to your own channel Indian Defense Analysis, where we bring to you all the latest development happening in the defense sector. As we all know that indigenous aircraft carrier ISC Vikrant will be commissioned by August 2022 and Navy will require deck-based fighters to operate from it. As per the latest news, France is likely to bring the naval version of Rafale aircraft, that is Rafale Marine or M, to India to showcase its ability to carry out a ski jump, which is a crucial takeoff capability to operate from Vikrant. In this video, we will discuss in detail about offering of Dassault Aviation, requirement of Indian Navy, and analyze the capability and compatibility of Rafale M for ISC Vikrant. We'll also talk about the compatibility of Rafale M with the lift of ISC Vikrant. So, let's get started. As per the latest update, Dassault has planned to test Rafale M from the shore-based test facility at INS Hansa, Goa. The date and time of testing is still awaited, but most probably this test will be conducted after 6th of January 2022. The Rafale M fighter will be pushed through intensive trials for nearly 12 days to assess whether the fighter aircraft is best suited for ISC Vikrant. The Rafale M is designed for CATOBAR, that is catapult takeoff but arrested recovery landing and takeoff. However, Indian aircraft carrier is designed to have STOBAR, that is short takeoff but arrested recovery landing and takeoff. During the trial, the Dassault Aviation wants to showcase Rafale's STOBAR capability and stay in the race of Indian Navy's twin engine carrier fighter jet requirement. Additionally, the Indian Navy is also planning to test US F-18 Hornet fighter at the same facility apparently in March as an alternative option to Rafale M fighters. There has always been debate related to the hangar lift of ISC Vikrant. The lifts are used to bring fighter jets from the hangar to the flight deck. The size of the lift are usually designed and planned thinking ahead of all the future assets that Navy plans to deploy. Navy has officially said that these lifts are big enough to accommodate MiG-29K and Rafale M. Now let's look into the wingspan of the few aircraft which Navy is and will operate. TEDBF will have wingspan of 11.2 meters. Rafale M will have 10.9 meters and MiG-29K has wingspan of 11.99 meters. The hangar of Vikrant has dimension of around 16.5 by 11.2 meters, that is 11.2 meters wide, though this is not officially stated by Navy. Therefore, Vikrant should not have any issues in operating these fighters. It's also very unrealistic to think that Dassault will offer its best fighter jet to Indian Navy without cross-checking for its compatibility. Talking about the requirement of Indian Navy for deck-based fighters, the Navy had initially floated a request for information in 2017 to procure 57 twin-engine carrier fighters and responses were being evaluated. As per the earlier reports, the number of fighters were to be downsized from 57 to 36. Although final decision is still awaited, there are possibilities that number of fighters could be further downsized and most probably it will be around 20 to 25 considering the deck requirement of Vikrant. The focus is on prioritizing the development of new indigenous twin engine carrier based deck fighter TEDBF, which is being designed and developed by DRDO and Aeronautical Development Agency ADA. This was today's update. Please let us know what is your views about these in comment section. Feel free to post your comments and suggestions about any topic related to defense sector on which you want to hear from us. With this, I would like to say goodbye and Jai Hind friends. Please like and subscribe our video if you have not done already. We'll be soon back with more interesting and amazing development happening in defense sector.